had a ride, a few polygel, and a few kits, along with a few rhinestones and charms. So we're gonna take the time with this video to do a few swatches and put away the new charms. So these are two polygels that I had gotten off of Amazon, mainly because I thought the bottles was very pretty. So we can swatch these and kind of see how it go. They had, I believe, three other ones. I think they had a clear and then like a light pink and then like a nude pink. I'm not a big fan of like nude pink, so I didn't go with them. And I said if I did like these ones, I will go back and get the clear. But we're gonna start with just swatching these two and then we'll go through the other ones. Just grab a few swatch sticks. I usually, when I do my little swatch sticks, I usually just kind of put like a nickname or something to them, or just a few of the letters of the name on the sticks. I don't do a whole lot to that. So what is that red? And then new. Let me see. I think I may have. Did we already? Okay, no. So I didn't take this one off. The red one. But these are, I'm going to throw the boxes away so that don't matter there. But these are 60 grams. I never tried this brand. But like I said, the bottles are super cute. They are a huge size. I have pretty big hands. And you can see the size of that bottle. Okay, so we already did take the little clear backing off of that one. So we just... Oh, you know what? Let me get some alcohol right quick. And a brush. And just this little rag over that. Let me damp my brush before I get started. And I'll take these two out. I tried to get them in the trash can. They did fall. But I'll go back and clean that. Alright, so we're going to take the new one. I like to squeeze my bottles from the bottom to help to prevent air bubbles and to help keep the seams from busting open. So straight out the bottle, it seems a little thick, which I prefer a thick, solid polygel. So far that seemed to be a little bit on the thicker side. Again, I won't fully know until I actually do a set with it. This one feel a little looser than the nude one did. It's coming out a little more easier. I might just go back and get the other ones anyway, just because the bottles are super cute. So I'm just going to damp my brush. Actually, let's start with new, just in case the red one is, in case it bleeds. Okay, so it is fairly stiff, which I like. It is requiring a bit of pressure. I had a little air bubble underneath. Alright, so let's go with the red one. Which this red is very pretty. Actually, I think my next set will be red. Yeah, the red is super pretty. It's like a... It look a little bit on the neonish side. It's not sticky. And it is fairly stiff. So I do think I'm going to go back and get the clear one. And probably the pink, one of the pink ones too. They was like $6.99, I believe. But I will me cure that. I will put the link in the description. While that's curing right quick, we'll jump right into the next one. So this one, I also got this one from Amazon. If I didn't say that about these ones, I got these from Amazon also. This one came from Amazon. It's a 2B Glam Kit. Collection kit, whatever you prefer to call it. Come with a bunch of random stuff. I just pretty much just need the polygels out of them. So we'll pop all of those out. And I do believe I already took the clear backings off just so I can get an idea of what they look like. And so, real quick, while these ones did cure, let me wipe the sticky layer off of it. So yes, the red do bleed a little bit. I don't know if you guys can really see it, but it do bleed, but not too big of a deal. Okay, now this new one, now I did cure for 30 seconds. The new one may require a 60 seconds because when I was wiping the sticky layer, the whole thing was actually kind of moving. So I will put that back in. But these are the two colors. Y'all don't mind my little watch. But they are the two colors. The red is super pretty and I think I'm going to use that. But let me put those ones back in. Alright, now we'll go into these ones. Actually, let me get some swatch sticks right quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's see. Okay, so these have names. And so on the swatch sticks, I'm just going to write 2. And then, actually, I'm going to just write 2. Yeah, just 2. And then the names. Actually, let me do 2B. And then the name. The name of the color. Then we have charm, all that, and then infatuation. So someone asked me why I don't use like a label maker, mainly because I like things, everything should have a place, everything should go where it's supposed to go, but I'm not that type of organized person where I'm, everything needs to be in clear containers or need labels and stuff. That's not me, and so I'm not going to use a label maker. Most of the times, I am going to remove these off the ring at some point and then throw them in a box, and so I don't want to have to, do a whole lot of unnecessary, labeling when they're going to be removed off the ring at some point. But this, that was infatuation. And then this one is pretty. Okay, pretty is stiff. I needed two hands to kind of squeeze that out. Okay, wink. And again, I kind of got these ones because the bottles. Anytime a potty gel have a different color bottle other than the typical black bottle, I tend to buy them regardless of what color the potty gel is. I just kind of like the different color bottles on my shelves. And so that's a lot of time. That's why I'll buy them. This one was shining. I believe this kit was $9.99 on Amazon. This one didn't, this was more like a half a bottle. It didn't have a whole lot, but the color is pretty. I do believe I have this color in another kit or another brand, but that color is pretty. Then we have charm. Oh, this is very pretty. And then all that. Oh, I like this one too. The air bubble squeezed right out from the beginning. So that is a plus for me, because then I don't have to worry about the big air bubble being in the center of the tube. And I also like that color. I believe I have that color also. I think that's like a Rosalind color I have. But anyway. Alright, so let me get the little rag, dip my brush, start with the lighter color. And it's not sticky because I'm having to wipe all the alcohol off my brush. So that is a plus. And it is a bit firm. And I really could have added a little bit more to this swatch stick. But the color is pretty. This is Wink. Put that in the light so they can cure. This one was Charm, which I absolutely love this color. So I'm thinking that I'm definitely going to do like a pink red type set next, because I want to use this color. And I did like that red from the other brand. That is really pretty. And I don't think I have that color at all. Okay, so that's Charm. This one is Pretty. Again, fairly stiff. Do not require a whole lot of slip, but it does require a bit more pressure. And then this just straight from out the tube. Of course, I won't really know how I feel about the texture until I use it for a set. Alright, let's go in with All That. Which I don't have this color. I thought this was like that Rosalind color I had. But I think this one seems to be a little bit darker than that Rosalind one. It might be the same. I don't know once I put it on the swatch stick. But that was All That. And then this one was Shining. Okay, that one is sticky. So, yeah, this glitter one is a sticky one. And it's a lot looser than the, I'm sorry, y'all say a lot. But this one is a lot looser than the solid colors. And then Infatuation. Again, this one is, hold on, let me see. It might not be as sticky as the other one. I'm not sure. Maybe I just got a lot of alcohol on my brush. But I ain't gonna lie, I do not like this color at all. So I most likely will not be using it. But that is that one. So I'm gonna give those a quick cure. And then kind of push these to the side for now. Let me see if anything else. Okay, no, that's all that came in it, was the polygels and a little card. I believe the little card was maybe like a little thank you card or something. Okay, just instructions. Yeah, just instructions, but I'm going to wind up throwing this away anyway. Okay, while those two are curing, let me go ahead and get them 4/16 cured. Over a little bit. We have two other kits. Again, y'all, I am a polygel junkie. Like, I love this stuff. I absolutely love it. I'm constantly checking for new kits. I'm also waiting for a few new tubes from AliExpress. So I am a polygel junkie. And what I tend to do is I'll just rearrange my wall every time some new ones come in. And so I'll take down some of the older ones that's closer to the top and make space for my new ones. But now we have two kits from Model One's kit collections. One day somebody was like, it's not a kit, it's a collection if it don't come with a brush. So whatever you want to call it, kit collection, whatever. Alright, so this one pretty much is just the six colors, your box, and then some instructions. Again, we don't need that, so we put that to the side. Let's start with this one, then we'll come back to the second one. Let me grab a few more swatch sticks. And I'm just going to write model on the swatch sticks. And then they have what, numbers? Model 330. Model 328. Model 326. 331. 329. 327. I don't have the best handwriting, but it do what it do. All right, and so these ones, I did not take the silver things off yet. Obviously, they just came in yesterday. So we'll take them off. This was what, 327. Ooh. Ooh, this one is pretty. Yeah, I think I'm going to do a pink and red set. Do I have this color? I think my other neon pinks is a little darker than this. I don't know. Let me see. That was pretty. 329. Okay. Okay, so this is just a whole neon kit. With pink, a orange. Ooh, this is a blue. Okay, it looks a little greenish on the label, but it is a very pretty blue. I don't know. Now I'm thinking I might just go ahead and do another neon set. For you guys who don't know, I am a neon lover. I love bright, pretty colors. And so now I don't know if I want to do the red set or a neon set. Okay, Model One. Y'all got a lot of little cute colors. I do have this color for sure. Bunch of times. This one is 328. I definitely have this color a bunch of times. That's like a typical yellow that come in a lot of the kits, especially like the neon ones. And so that's why when I did my last set, I really loved that yellow because it wasn't that yellow. It was more like a regular everyday yellow, well, everyday spring type yellow. And I believe I have that. It might be a little lighter or a little darker, but for the most part, I do have that purple. Let me move this one in. Alright, so let's get some alcohol. Okay, let me clean this brush right quick because I do have colors coming out of it. Let's start with the lighter color. Okay, yellow. It's a little loose, but it's not sticky. Again, I have this yellow. I'm gonna move these ones over in the light. Oh, you know what? Let me swatch these and then I'll pull the other ones out so you can get a good view. purple one. All of these, okay, hold up, before I say that, but for the most part, yeah, these ones are all a little bit loose, a little more runny compared to the other two kits that I got, or the other two brands of polygels that I just done. But it's no big deal. It's not runny to the point. It's not runny to the point you can't use it. Again, that pink and that blue is super cute. And I think, let me see, because I might can do like a pink, blue, and that red. Make a little kit. Make a set out of that. That is the orange one. Now this pink one. Okay. Well, that is curing. Let me grab these ones right quick. I think it's okay. This one and this one go there. These ones go with the 2B glam set. Okay, and now for the last. There we go. Another model one, just the box and the instructions. I'm just gonna take these out. I'm gonna get some sticks. And then these are also numbers. And I believe both of these kits was $9.99 also. I have to go back and check. So I buy a lot of polygels because I don't like to use polish. I like to just go ahead and use the polygel, and that is my design. I don't like to go back and have to add like polish and stuff like that. So that's why I tend to buy a lot of polygels. Alright, so let's take these off. I gotta get some tweezers. Yeah. Dang, I can't get that one off at all. I'll come back to that one. Okay, that's what, 42. A pretty one. Now these ones aren't so much in season, but it's good to, for me at least, it's good to have all the colors. And the kit was just like really cheap. So that was another reason why I got it. These little things hard to come off. Okay, that was 27. That's pretty. A cute little nude color. $277. Mm, I mean, it's a cute color, I guess. Not for me. I don't really like to use like whites and stuff. That's not really my thing. But it's cute, I guess. Like, I don't know why they stuck. I can't even bite them off. Let's try this one. Alright, I think I'm gonna have to, which I hate having to open my polygels like that. I can't even. I'm just gonna take some tweezers. I'll go back later and clean all the little silver off, but just for the sake of the video. Get them open. This is so annoying. Like, I don't even think I'm gonna be able to squeeze this one out at all. Let's see. Okay, this is 320. The color is super pretty. Absolutely like the color. Hate that I can't get it open. But the color is pretty. This one is 321. Another pretty color. I was a little hesitant about this kit at first, mainly because I'm like, it's out of season and I won't get around to using it. But I definitely think I will use this kit during the spring, summer. Kind of mix it in with some bright colors. Alright, so let's get the brush, clean it out. Alright, let's stop the little whitish tan. It's smooth for the most part. It's a little more sticky. A little nudist color, which I think I have this color from them, from another kit. It could be a little different, but it seemed like one of the other colors I had from our model one. But that color is super pretty, a great little nail bed color. This one I love. So I think I have an idea for the next set. Let me put a little more alcohol. Because this whole kit is just a tad bit more stickier than the previous kit. So the neon kit, this one is a little more sticky. But it's the same when it comes down to the texture of it. It's the same consistency, just a little sticky. And it's something stuck in that. Okay, this is cute too. I actually like these little colors from this kit. And this, I know I have this color. Not from Model 1, but I know I have this from Savvyland and Roslyn. And I think that's, wait a minute, what is that brand called? Maeezy? Miss something. But I know I have that color because I used that before with like a sprinkle or sparkle blue. But, okay, while that one is curing, let me clean this stuff up right quick. We'll push it to the side. That way I can lay the kit out with the color. All right, so let's start with these two here. Let me move it up a little bit. So wait, the other ones are not in the frame. So these two here, 60 gram bottles, and they sold in individual tubes. They do have other colors, and these are the two colors out of the tube. Very, very close to the color on the bottle. So that is a plus, but those are the colors. It wasn't sticky. It was very stiff, easy to use. I like a stiff poly gel, so that's why I say it's easy for me to use. But that is those two colors. And then put them to the side. Now we have 2B Glams. Let's put the two glitters. Those are the bottles, super cute. And then let's start from the bottom on. They need to be wiped off. That is that one. A little lighter, actually quite a bit lighter from the sticker. So that's that one. And then we have that one. Okay, this one, which I want to use this color. Different from the bottle, but the color is very pretty. This one. Winks, another pretty color. For the most part, other than the glitters, I did like every color that came in this kit. So this kit was a like, and that's pretty. I do like this color. I would like to use this one. And then the last one from that kit is that one. And kind of put them all together. I'm trying to put all the little colors together. And that is those colors from that kit. And then the model one neon kit. I'm trying to clean them off. Alright, so we have the yellow. Then the green one. The purple. The pink one. The blue one, and then the orange one from that one. And the last of the polygel. some of these do bleed, especially like the darker ones. Okay, so that is like a white with a hint of a tan color to it. That is this one. 20, super pretty. 321. 242. And then 27. Okay, so those were all of the poly gels. At a later time, I will go back and put them on the rings, color with the other, well, I put color code my rings, so I'll put them on the rings with the other colors that is similar to it. Okay, thank you guys for watching my poly gel swatches. Hope you guys are able to at least get a good idea of what the colors look like from the kit, because a lot of times the bottles and the colors aren't actually the same. But thank you guys.